and deliver him from all of his trouble. Oh my God, we got to taste and see that the Lord is good. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you for your faithfulness, God. Thank you for your love, God. Thank you, God, for your power, God. In the name and in the blood of Jesus. Father, we know that earth is the Lord. And the fullness thereof. The world and all his people belong to him. He has founded upon the seas. He has established upon the waters. Who may climb the mountain of the Lord? Who may stand in his holy place? Only those with clean hands and a pure heart. Those who have not lifted their soul to an idol. Are sworn deceitfully. They may receive the blessings of the Lord. And right standing with the God of Israel. For we are the generation that seek him. That seek his face, O Jacob. So come on and lift up you gates, all you gates. And be lift up the everlasting doors. And the King of glory, and the Lord of Messiah, shall come in his place. Who is the King of glory? His Lord, powerful and mighty. Mighty in our battle. Oh, come on and bless him. Oh, come on and bless him. We got reason to celebrate. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Wonderful Savior. Wonderful Jesus. Father, we thank you, Lord. From the bottom of our heart, God. We thank you for your faithfulness, God. You say you never leave us. You say you never forsake us, God. And you're not a man that you should lie. I'm a son of man that you should repent. And you said it, God. You made it good. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, God. Hallelujah, God. For the prophet Isaiah said, and the year that King Uzziah died, a house of the Lord, high and lifted up, and the train of his robe began to fill the temple. And above these new seven angels, each having six wings, and with two they covered their eyes, and with two they covered their feet, and with two they began to fly. And they looked at one another, said, holy, 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 for the whole world is filled with the glory of God. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Father, we thank you, God. We thank you, Lord. Father, we thank you. Hallelujah. Come on and lift holy hands and worship him. Come on, let's worship him. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Jesus. Come on, let's welcome his presence in his place. Yes, Lord. My God.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
Yes, God.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Wonderful Jesus. Wonderful Jesus. He's a faithful God.
Hallelujah.
He's a faithful God. Yes, Lord Jesus.
Yes, Lord. Help your children.
Oh, yes, God.
Don't let them fall,
Jesus,
by the side of the road,
Jesus,
and teach them,
Jesus,
to Jesus. Love one another,
yes,
and tell them I find,
yes,
a place in their heart.
Yes, Lord.
Standing here,
Jesus,
not knowing how we'll get through the test.
Jesus, my God.
But holding on to faith, you
yes, Lord. Bear. Jesus,
nothing can thank catch you, you by surprise. You got it figured out. You're watching us now.
My God. Lord. Come on, let us clap our hands, all you people. Come on, let's clap our hands, all you people. And let's begin to shine unto God with the voice of triumph. Hallelujah. Oh, come on and bless him. Come on and bless him. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord. Wonderful thing. And turn it down there. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Wonderful Savior. Wonderful Savior. Wonderful Jesus. Lord, we give you the praise, God. Father, we give you the glory, God. Father, there's none like you in all the earth, God. We can search the world all over, God, to find none like you, Lord. For truly, you are the King of Kings, and you are the Lord of Lords. You are the ruler of the nation, God. Who is, who was, who is still yet to come, God. You are the only wise God. You are Jehovah Rapha. You are the God that heals. You are Jehovah Roha. You are our shepherd, and we shall not want, O God. You are Jehovah Jireh. You are our provider, Lord God. You are Jehovah Shalom. You give us peace in the midst of a chaotic world. You are Jehovah Nisi, O God. You are our victor and our banner, Lord God. You are Jehovah Makadesh, God. You are our sanctifier, O God. Father, you are El Elyon, God. You are the Most High, God. You are El Shaddai, God. You are God. You are God Almighty, Lord God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Wonderful Savior. He's a faithful God. He's a faithful God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord God. Father, we give you the praise, God. Father, we give you the glory, Lord. And Father, as we stand, Lord God, we confess every sin, Father, knowing you are faithful and just to forgive us and cleanse us from all unrighteousness, Lord God. And because of the shed blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, Father, you said you choose not to remember the things we said or done. So, Father, if you so choose not to remember the things we have said or what we have done, then, God, we would not be deceived to allow the enemy to interject thoughts in our mind to bring condemnation, Lord God. For you said there is no condemnation for those of us that are in Christ Jesus that walk not after the flesh but after your spirit, O God. And, Father, we thank you that you gave us your very best gift, your only begotten Son, Jesus. Whosoever believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And Father, we thank you that you will leave the 99 to go find that one, oh God. And we thank you, Lord, for the agape love, the unconditional love that you have us as your son and daughter. For you told us to come out from amongst them and be ye separated, touch not the unclean things, that you may receive us, that you would be our father, and we would be your sons, and we would be your daughters. And Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, God. That we can stand boldly now, God. Hallelujah. And give you praise and to give you glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. New life, we got reason to celebrate. Hallelujah. We got reason to give him praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's a faithful Father. Hallelujah. A faithful Father. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Wonderful Savior. Woo! Wonderful Savior. We thank Chantel for setting the atmosphere for the glory of the Lord. Hallelujah. Nothing like his presence. Hallelujah. And giving honor to my wife Kelly and to my daughter Praise, my family. Giving honor to you, New Life, here in Danville and Champaign. To all the leaders, Deacon Lyles, to all the leaders. And to all of you who have joined us, New Life, on social media. Hallelujah. Praise God. Again, on behalf of our pastor, Pastor Thomas Miller, First Lady Beverly Miller, amen. Again, want to thank everyone. Fasting, you're standing in the gap, establishing your phone lines of prayer. and interceding for our first lady, and interceding for our pastor, amen. For the eyes of God have been opened, and the ears of God have been attentive to the prayers that were made, hallelujah. And we thank God for his faithfulness, amen. And also to you again, New Life Church of Faith in Champaign and Danville, again, on behalf of our pastor, first lady, thank you for allowing God to use your gifts to continue to perfect the ministry here at New Life Church of Faith, amen. For the day will come, you will hear Pastor Miller from his very own voice, from the bottom of his heart, thanking you, amen. So again, we thank you, New Life, and we thank you, the leadership team especially, amen. But we want to continue to stay on this front line of spiritual warfare. We want to continue to stay on the front line of battle, to continue to intercede. For we are in a war, church, we are in a war. And there's no time to surrender, and there's no time to retreat. There's no time to get into lukewarmness, to be deceived by the enemy. We are in an invisible war. Amen. We continue on to pray for Minister Tia. Her brother John is in the hospital. He's fighting against the coronavirus. So remember John in your prayer. Remember him as we intercede for him. Amen. Hallelujah. Continue praying for the for Mother Dukes and Elder Dukes and the passing of Mother Dukes' mother. Amen. Continue praying for our very own Elder George Rose, who is being restored. Amen. His wife, brother, continue to give her strength. Amen. We on the battlefield. We ain't got time to come off the front line. Really ain't got time to rest. Amen. We continue to fight this good fight of faith. Amen. New Life, we have been drafted. Amen. And we got to continue in this the army of the Lord Jesus Christ, for he have trained our hands to fight and our fingers to war. Amen. So we are in a war, and we are fighting the good fight of faith. Amen. And we got Jesus Christ as our commander-in-chief, so we cannot lose. Hallelujah. Woo. Thank you, Jesus. Woo. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. Continue to be reminded of Wednesday, 7 o'clock Bible study. Every Wednesday at 7 p.m., we have our very own Minister Teal going to be teaching this Wednesday. We're also reminded of Saturday, 7 a.m. morning glory prayer. Amen. New Life Sunday morning glory prayer. Amen. Also, the Zoom Sunday school at 9:45 is up and running. Minister Odette is teaching that along with Minister Charlene. Amen. That's at 9:45 a.m. on Zoom Bible study. So again, on behalf of Pastor Sister Miller, New Life, and the leadership team, thank you for allowing God to use your gifts in perfecting the ministry. Amen. Pastor Miller is proud, and our first lady is proud. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Well, I tell you, New Life, as I am standing here in the midst of why I am speaking, we are in one of the most remembered and one of the most celebrated day ever in the existence of New Life Church of Faith. And why am I saying this? Because this is the day that our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, our Heavenly Father, this is the day that he have raised up our pastor, Pastor Thomas Miller, woo! From that, not his sickbed, from that sickbed that have cost the lives of over 1 million people in this world and over 237,000 in these United States of America. But God have heard our prayer, and we stood in the gap for our very own Pastor Thomas Miller, and God have raised him up out of that sickbed. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. And we can't forget, New Life. We can't forget the faithfulness of God. Hallelujah. For God said in Psalms 118, listen to this, of the 23rd and the 24th verse of Psalm 118, God said, this was the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes. This is the day that the Lord God has made, and we choose to rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. Hallelujah. Woo! Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. New Life, listen to me. And those of you that are in social media, listen to me. It's very, very important. We cannot allow the spirit of religion and cultural church tradition spiritually blind us from the faithfulness of God And listen to this. And from the magnitude of God's timing of his prophetic word that he spoke to us on last Sunday, November the 1st of 2020, listen to this, and then confirm what he spoke to us on November the 1st of 2020. He then confirmed that very word the next day, Monday, November the 2nd, 2020. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We can't forget. We can't forget. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God said in Jeremiah 1 and 12, he said, I'll watch over my word to perform it. Hallelujah. And we thank the Lord. And we thank the Lord for his faithfulness. Hallelujah. And just in case, New Life, just in case you don't remember, and those of you who wasn't here on last Sunday or just happened to be on social media today, let me remind you of what God said by coming with a divine interruption and interrupt me from preaching what I wanted to preach. And God said, remind my people of my faithfulness, of what he said last Sunday. And I want to remind you. And then as he spoke that to us and then confirmed it the next day. We talk about the faithfulness of God that heard our prayers. Hallelujah. Yeah. It goes to show you, New Life, you are some very powerful sons and daughters of God with authority and power. Yeah. Woo. To call those things that be not as though they were. Yeah. And for those of us that was lacking in any type of measure of faith, yeah, let me remind you of what was said on last Sunday. And then what he did the very next day. And he said, son, tell my people the last Sunday, November the 1st, is to be a memorial. And November the 2nd is to be a monument forever in the existence of New Life Church of Faith. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Well, you remember on last Sunday when I was preparing to preach, praying but not believing, I had all my notes together ready to teach and preach that thing. Let me quickly remind you. And God said, no, son, I'm coming with a divine interruption that you may remind my people, that you may give a testimony of my faithfulness, not knowing what God was going to do the next day. But now I understand the urgency. Now I understand the interruption. Why he wanted to say what he wanted to say. So let me quickly remind you of what happened November the 1st of 2020 on last Sunday. You heard me say on last Sunday how on October the 9th and October the 10th is when I had talked to Pastor Miller when he was in Danville Hospital. And after finished talking with him, I began to pray. And I began to pray hard because God did give us an emotional, healthy fear that would cause us to pray hard. And as I was praying hard, you remember God began to again put in my mind Psalms 91. Yeah. And so I began to read Psalms 91 just to see what God wanted to show me, because the whole entire chapter of Psalms 91 is powerful. So as I began to read Psalms 91, I got down to the last two verses, 15 and 16. You see, understand, God was teaching me how to pray for our pastor. And I know I wasn't the only one. He was teaching you too. And as I got down to the 15th and 16th verse and began to read as follows. He shall call upon me. Now let me share this with you, something I did share last Sunday when I talked to Pastor Miller on October the 9th and October the 10th. And as we were hanging up the phone, I heard him call on the name Jesus. Jesus, Jesus. And then God guided me to the 15th and 16th verse of Psalms 91. This is what God said. He will call upon me and I will answer him, and I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life will I satisfy him and show him my salvation. So as I read that, the Spirit of God was teaching me, you are to pray this scripture every day over your pastor, Pastor Miller. He's a faithful God. He's a faithful God. So as I begin to pray that prayer, amen, and then on October the 11th, you heard me say, our days leading up to October the 11th, the first day I was to mount this platform and preach in the space of our pastor, not because he was on vacation this time, but because he was in the hospital. And I was crying out to God, having my very own pity party. I was saying to God, God, my heart is heavy, God, and it's very hard for me to mount this platform, God, and preach in the space of our pastor, God, because he's in the hospital. And I'm having my very own pity party, but I dare not allow you to see that. It was in the comfort of my own home by myself. So I'm crying out to God. I said, God, you got to show me something, God. God, you got to tell me something, God, that when I mount this platform, that I can teach and preach with the joy of my salvation. Because, God, I don't know how much longer I can mount this platform with a heart that is heavy.
Yes, yes.
You remember what I said on that Sunday, how God led us New Life in a dark place. New Life Church of Faith, Danville, New Life Church of Faith, Champaign. He led us in a dark place where we could not see his hand, but we had to learn to trust his heart for our pastor.
Yes.
It's in that dark place, New Life, that you cannot forget. It was in that dark place where the more we prayed in faith, Satan was coming with fear upon the mind. The more we pray with confidence, Satan was attacking the mind with doubt. The more we pray trusting God, Satan would come with worry upon the mind. We were in a dark place, but God says in a dark place where I grow and I script your faith from that of a major faith, is Romans 12 and 3, to that of unfringed faith, which that is true faith, and 2 Timothy 1, 5, that you may have great faith, Matthew chapter 8. God don't waste nothing. Understand, God could have healed our pastor 1 minute or 1 hour in that same day.
Yes, Lord.
So we're in a dark place, New Life. And all the while we're in this dark place, God carried our pastor through his prophetic tunnel of healing and restoration. And God said, New Life, I got you in this dark place to stretch and to grow your faith in me. Because it's only the dark place when you can't see my hand while I teach and grow your faith. Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
So in the dark place, I said, God, I don't know how much longer I can take. So I'm sitting on the side of my bed, having my pity party, and I went to sleep. So God answered my prayer. He gave me, or should I say, he answered my pity party. And he gave me a prophetic dream. And in that dream, you heard me say that our very own Deacon Lyle will mount this platform. And he was giving a testimony in tears of how the burden was lifted. The burden of heaviness, the burden of worry, and the burden of doubt. How he was weighing it down for his pastor. And when God lifted that burden, Deacon Lyle's in the pulpit testifying of the joy of the Lord. For raising up our pastor. That was the dream. The faithfulness of God.
Yeah.
And then in New Life, he gave us that prophetic word of where he's taking New Life Church of Faith, all the while carrying our pastor through his prophetic tunnel of healing and restoration. Remember, I told you, it's very dangerous if I even try to tell the full reign of what all God have imparted prophetically and the revelation knowledge he have given our pastor. I can only tell you droplets of the full reign that God have put inside our pastor while he was carrying him through the prophetic tunnel of healing and deliverance. But we should hear on that day. But this is what he said. I'm going to read this, and then we'll go on with today's word of today. This is the prophetic word, New Life, that we should never forget. We cannot allow the spirit of religion and culture, church, tradition to hear the word of God as to what he's doing. And we just say, oh God, we thank you. You'll hear our pastors and we go on to the next phase of religion. The devil is a lie. November the 1st is to be used as a memorial. November the 2nd, the day he raised pastor off that sick bed, it should be used as a monument. Hallelujah. And I'm going to write it down. I want you to write it down. And those on social media, I want you to write down in the name of Jesus. November the 1st, a memorial of 2020. And November the 2nd, a monument. That we don't forget the faithfulness of God. So that when trials and tribulations come knocking at your door, that you can remember when you was in the dark place interceding for your pastor and how God raised him up. So let me read this prophetic word, no, like then we'll get on with today's teaching. This was Thursday at 3:37 a.m. on October the 29th. I'm at work, minding my own business, and Spirit of the Lord began to talk, and I went running for a scratch piece of paper. It's very important, New Life, that when God began to speak, we stop doing what we're doing and begin to hear and see what God is saying. He that have an ear, let him hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And that's what he said, New Life. From Deuteronomy 29:29, he said, the secret things belong to the Lord, but what I reveal is for you and your children. He said, what Satan meant for evil, I meant for good. For I am the Lord God of your salvation. My church, New Life Church of Faith, I'm taking you to a higher ground. Now understand that higher ground is promotion in the ranks of authority in greater realms, greater dimensions, and greater spiritual territory. So in other words, New Life, you may not feel like it, but you are being promoted in the realm of the spirit. Right. Hallelujah. But you cannot dare allow the spirit of religion to get you to miss out on what God is saying. I'm taking you to a higher ground in the spirit, a new spiritual life that the enemy knows not. For this higher ground in the spirit realm, New Life, will require you putting your faith in the right perspective. And that perspective is in me, for I am a jealous God. My servant, my set man, whom I chose over this house, New Life Church of Faith, is a man of God with integrity, which is the foundation of the kingdom of heaven. And I have found him, Thomas Miller, to be faithful and faithful through the test as Job. I am revealing, I am reintroducing myself to him in many different prophetic streams while I am carrying him through my prophetic tunnel of healing and restoration. God said, New Life Church of Faith, be not afraid. Yeah. He spoke that to us on November the 1st of 2020 on last Sunday. Then the very next day, November the 2nd, 2020, God is not a man that he should lie, the son of man that he should repent. Had he said it, he did it. But raised up our pastor from this sick bed, where our very own Sister Miller could go and visit him and talk with him. And been visiting and talking with him ever since. Hallelujah. Understand the magnitude of the timing, New Life, of God's prophetic word, and then confirming that word the very next day. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want to say this before we get into today's teaching. And I don't know who I'm talking to. Maybe somebody in here, or maybe somebody in social media. But I feel the prompting and the urging of God to say this. We cannot, New Life, for the life of us, allow ourselves to get in lukewarmness right now. Satan going to try with all the forces of hell. Because we really can't gather ourselves together like we should because of the law of the land. So Satan will try to come and pick us up one by one. Through the desires of the flesh, use our very own five senses to plant thoughts in the conscious mind of our soul to pull us like a lost sheep. Let me tell you something, New Life. You may deal a thing. But repent, confess that sin. He's faithful and just to forgive and get back on this warfare because New Life Church of Faith, we are going somewhere to a higher ground in the spirit. And you can't afford to be left behind. So if you know somebody, New Life, who have kind of fallen back, give them a call. them a call quickly. I ain't trying to be biased of any other church, but God is taking New Life Church of Faith to a place in the realm of the spirit. He have taken very few churches. Hallelujah. So we got to stand the front line and fight this good fight of faith. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now the prophetic word, it said that God would have taken our pastor through the test, asked Job. You remember what Job said in Job 42 and 5 after Job went through the test? Job said, I have heard of God with the hearing of my ears, but now my eyes have seen him. And Pastor Miller, I know he has heard of God with the hearing of his ears, but now his eyes have seen him. And I'm not talking about physical eyes. I'm talking about the eyes of his understanding. The same eyes that Apostle Paul prayed for the church of Ephesians. In Ephesians chapter 1, starting the 17th verse, Paul said, ever since I heard of your love and your faith towards each other, I never cease to lift you in my prayer, praying that the God and Father of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ may give unto you the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him, that the eyes of your understanding being enlightened, that you may know what is the hope of his calling and what are the riches of the glory of the inheritance in the saints. Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
Ladies and gentlemen, our paths will never be the same. I can tell you, I can't tell you the full range of all what God has shown him and have imparted it into him. But I will tell you, he's been promoted in the realm of the spirit with not anointing, but with mantles. And where the head go, we go, the body go. That's why God's going to take you to a higher ground. But I'm going to say this again, like you cannot, we cannot allow the spirit of culture, church, tradition, nor the spirit of religion to say, oh, that sound good. Oh, thank God he raised up pastor. Oh, that sound good at all. And miss what God is doing. It would grieve and quench you.
My God.
We don't want to grieve the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So it's time to catch on fire, new life. It's time to catch on fire. Hallelujah. And say, we'll use your job, he'll use your husband, he'll use your wife, he'll use your kids, your grandkids, to get you out of position with God. Let nothing get us out of position with God. We was born in a rushing position, but that's another position we got to keep ourselves in. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's get into today's teaching. Hallelujah. Well, I tell you, it's going to be a part two to this world. I tell you that now, going to be a part two. God always coming with divine interruption. That's okay. We always want to be on his agenda, not my agenda. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. They're going to ask you, how Pastor Miller doing? I want you to say, we going someplace higher in the spirit. Hallelujah. I'm excited, y'all. I'm excited in this season of New Life Church of Faith. I'm excited. God said, my thoughts ain't your thoughts. My ways ain't your ways. Just as high as the heaven is upon earth, my thoughts and my ways higher than yours.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Well, this word praying but not believing, it is a word that God gave me as I was casually walking through the kitchen and I asked him on October the 25th. I said, Lord, what you want me to preach on next? It's on a Sunday when I left here. And the Spirit of the Lord said, I heard in my spirit praying but not believing. And I never thought in my mind that we as a body of Christ that can you actually pray and not believe? So I'm thinking this to myself, praying but not believing. And God put me in remembrance of Acts chapter 12, and it's very lengthy, so we really don't have time to read it, so I'm going to tell you about it. But homework assignment is I want you to read Acts chapter 12, the first through the 16th verse. I want you to read that over and over, at least three times. I want you to be looking out for how they was praying, yes, but not believing.
All right.
Acts chapter 12, homework assignment, the first through the 16th verse. Let that be your homework assignment. Read at least three times. Okay? Remember this prophetic word God said, we have to put our faith in the right perspective.
Amen.
It's going right along with this teaching. So in Acts chapter 12, as God gave me that title, praying but not believing, in Acts chapter 12, the first through the 16th verse, James, the son of Zebedee, your brother John were put in prison by King Agrippa, Herod Agrippa. They also called him King the Great. And he was put in prison. Then the next day, James was executed by being beheaded for preaching the gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And King Herod Agrippa, he saw how it pleased the people. So he went and had the order of Peter to be arrested. So he arrests Peter also for spreading the gospel and had Peter put in prison. And King Agrippa made sure that Peter could not escape. So he had two of his guards to be in the cell with Peter. One chained on the right hand of Peter and the other one chained on the left hand of Peter with his ankles and his wrists chained to the guards. Then he had two other guards standing at the outside of the prison doors to make sure that Peter don't escape. Mm-hmm. Seemed like an impossible escape. Mm-hmm. Well, the saints got together. They knew they could not overpower King Agrippa or the Roman soldier. So the saints got together secretly over Mary's house to pray, have a prayer meeting. Now, this is not Mary, Jesus' mother, or Mary Magdalene, or the Mary that washed Jesus' feet. Mary is a very common name in the Bible. It's about five Mary. This Mary here is the mother of John, the John that wrote the book of John. And they got together secretly over Mary's house at night for a secret prayer meeting. And they began to pray. Because they knew James was already dead. He was already executed for preaching the gospel. And they didn't want King Agrippa now to kill Peter. So they got together at night secretly to pray. And they had a prayer meeting. They began to pray. Well, also in the prayer meeting was a very young girl by the age of my daughter, Praise. Her name was Rhoda. So as they began to pray, as you read that, you're going to see that nobody in their prayer meeting have faith but this little old young girl named Rhoda. We're talking about seasoned saints, grown saints that have been walking this walk for a very long time, but they were praying, but understand they did not have faith. So as they began to pray, the only one that had faith in that room was Rhoda. And as they began to pray, they're going to knock at the door. And Rhoda, being excited, she went to the door and asked who is it, and he said, Peter. And Rhoda got so excited that she forgot to open the door. She went to the circle of the prayer meeting of the grown folks that have been walking this walk for such a long time. She said, hey, y'all, Peter is at the door. Now, how dare Rhoda interrupt the prayer meeting? They praying for Peter. Well, Mary and all the other folks in the prayer meeting said, you have lost your mind. There's no possible way that can be Peter. Wait a minute now. I'm reading this. I'm not waiting a minute now. How are you going to tell Rhoda she lost her mind? And we praying for Peter to be loose from that jail. But yeah, you praying. So when Rhoda said Peter said to don't, you said she crazy. And if that wasn't enough, Rhoda said, no, I'm not crazy. He said the door. And they said, there must be a ghost. Well, what they were saying, that Peter was already dead. So it must be Peter goes, wait a minute, and prayer meeting people. You in that prayer meeting, but you praying, but you don't believe.
Come on, here, preach
up. So Rhoda went open the door, and Peter come walking in.
Yes.
And he said, here I am.
Yes.
And so they began to look in amazement.
Uh-huh.
But Rhoda just jumping and shouting. And God began to tell me, as I read that, he said, son, they was praying, but they was not believing. They was praying because I exist, but they didn't have faith that I can move. So I moved on Rhoda's faith.
Uh-huh.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praying, but not believing. So isn't that something, how church tradition can go from generation to generation to generation? We praying because we believe in God exists, but we don't believe that God can move his hand. But we pray because mama taught me to pray. Grandmama taught me to pray. I pray because I know that's the right thing to do. But I'm praying, starting that prayer, and I'm ending that prayer. And that's only the first dimension of prayer. So God said, son, tell my people, listen to this, faith must be established in your heart before it can even come out your mouth. What are you saying, God? He said in Romans 10, verse 9 and 10, if you confess with your mouth and what? Believe in your heart. But I'm We pray with our faith ever being established in our hearts. And so the question is asked, are we like the people in the prayer meeting? Are we praying because we know that's the right thing to do? We just pray, believing in prayer but not believing in God to move in that situation. Turn with me to the book of Matthew chapter 11 and let's read this. Praying but not believing. Hallelujah. Mark chapter 11, starting with the 23rd verse. Praying but not believing. Praying is a proper thing to do. But are we praying? Believing. And you do know the second dimension is praying and believing, which is faith. And Hebrew chapter 11 verse 1 says, faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. And then in that sixth verse of chapter 11, God says it's impossible to please me without faith. So Satan, he want to stop us from praying. But if he can't stop us from praying, then he stop us from just praying and not going to the next dimension, praying and believing, which is faith. So look what the book of Mark said, chapter 11, start with 23rd verse. For surely I say to you that whosoever saith to this mountain, that's a mountain of trouble, trials, and tribulation in your lives, be thou removed and be cast into the sea, and do not doubt in your heart, but believe those things which he says will be done, and it will be done wherever he says. Look at 24. Therefore I say unto you, whatsoever thing you ask what? When you pray what? Believe. That you may what? Receive them, and you will have them. Understand something. In that scripture, heart is not talking about the heart in the middle of our chest that pump blood throughout our bodies. That word heart and soul is used interchangeably in the Bible. The heart that this Bible talking about, this Matthew chapter 11, 23 and 24 verse, is talking about your soul, which is your mind, your will, your emotion. Because this heart ain't nothing but a muscle, because it cannot die. So we talk about your soul. Say no. If I can't stop them from praying, then I'm going to stop them at prayer. And say, listen to this. Remember what I told you 3 weeks ago? He said, 2 Corinthians 4:4, saying this, the ruler of this world. So Satan will use the things in this world through our five senses, especially what we see and what we hear. He used our five senses to sow a seed of doubt in our heart, which is our soul, to get us to tear down whatever measure of faith that you may have when you pray. Amen. Now, unfortunately, we're going to leave it right here. Because we're running out of time. So they told me I got to shut down at 1. I had to train myself to do this. So next Sunday, we're going to get on part 2 of praying but not believing. And I want you to remind me where I stopped at to make sure you're paying attention. So we stopped at saying sowing a seed of doubt to make sure we're not praying with faith if he can't stop us from praying at all. His objective is to make sure we don't pray. So we go ahead and pray as mature sons and daughters. So then his second mandate is to make sure we don't pray believing, which is faith. So next Sunday, we're going to continue the teaching on making sure how we guard our heart. Because the Bible said, guard your heart. Because out of it flows the issues of life. He talked about the soul, which is our mind, our will, and our emotion. So next Sunday, we're going to teach how to guard your soul. That Satan don't sow a seed of doubt to tear down the walls of faith. That when I pray, I don't pray with faith to believe. Amen? Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we give you the praise. We give you the glory, God, of where you've taken us here at New Life Church of Faith. Father, we thank you for raising up our pastor off this sick bed and healing our first lady. Father, we thank you, God, for all the prophetic impartation and all the vision you have shown our pastor while carrying him through the prophetic tunnel of healing and restoration. And that, God, you take us to a higher ground in the spirit, God. And we thank you, God, that you do everything line upon line and precepts upon precept, as Isaiah 28 tells us. And even with this word, God, praying and not believing, God, we see that you're taking us, God, that we may have our faith and put it in the right perspective as the word you have given us. Yes. Father, allow this word not to fall on deaf ears, God. Let it bring a stirring in our hunger, God, in the name and in the blood of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. At this time, I want to make sure, ladies and gentlemen, we continue to sow our tithes and offering. Let me tell you something. This is a good place in this season to be sowing our tithes and offering. They're always a good place, but especially where God is taking us. Amen. So let us pray over our tithes and offering. Amen. Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus. You told us to give. It will be given back to us. Good measure, pressed down and shaken together, running over. Will you allow men to get back to our bosom, God? For if the same measure we give, that same measure will be given back to us. Father, you said from the book of Malachi, God, to bring our tithes into your house and test you. The only place in the word, God, you said we can test you concerning our tithes and offerings. Where you said test you, see, you would not open up the windows of heaven. Pour us out a blessing. We'll have room enough to receive. And Father, we give you the praise and glory in Jesus' name. Father, we continue to lift up John, Minister Teal's brother, God. We rebuke the spirit of premature death that may be hovering over John. Father, we speak because we know there's no dissonance in the spirit, Lord God. We command you, John, to rise up off that sick bed in the name and in the blood of Jesus Christ. We rebuke that spirit of infirmity off John right now. We declare, we decree that John will live and not die and declare the glory of the Lord. We command his heart to beat properly. We command his lungs to regulate properly in the name and in the blood of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Now, Father, we thank you for your faithfulness, God, raise up our pastor and healing our first lady. God, we pray for the blood of Jesus to cover New Life Church of Faith, God, in our families, in the name of Jesus Christ. Declare, decree, and no weapon form against us shall prosper in the name and in the blood of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. That you hide us behind a blood-stained banner, God, in the name and in the blood of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Father, we give you the praise, God. Father, we give you the glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Come on and clap your hands for the Lord. Hallelujah. Woo! Kelly just told my pastor's watching on Facebook Live. So come on, let's tell our pastor hallelujah. Hallelujah. And we love him. Hallelujah. Yes, hallelujah. Woo! He's watching and I know he's smiling. Hallelujah. Woo! Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is carried him through the prophetic tongue of healing. And now he's being restored. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. New life. We're going somewhere higher. Going somewhere higher. Amen. We continue to pray for Pastor Keys also. God, you continue to touch and heal him. Praying for our very own elder, George Rose. God, we thank you for his healing, God. And we give you praise, God. We lift up, God, in the name of Jesus. All the ones that may be sick, God, that you touch him, God. And in Jesus' name, God, we pray for mother right now in the name of Jesus Christ. God, we thank you in Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. Amen. Be safe. Wear your mask. Keep 6 feet distant. Wash your hand. And be safe. So we'll see you here next time. Amen. God bless you. Hallelujah.